detail-oriented directors are nothing new to cinema. Stanley Kubrick took over 100 takes on some scenes while shooting The Shining, and Francis Ford Coppola tore through each page of the Godfather novel, making notes on everything from where to place the camera to the expression on the character's face. There are plenty of other directors out there that one could define as a perfectionist, but one that sticks out to me is... Wes Anderson is a critically acclaimed director and writer known for films such as... Anderson's style is extremely recognizable and very unique compared to his film contemporaries. His films are colorful, yet subtle. There is a vintage influence for set and costume design, some deep cuts of music from the 60s or 70s, and what is most synonymous with Anderson's style, his use of symmetry. All of these elements play a role in what makes Wes Anderson such a perfectionist.
Is it different on set doing a Wes Anderson film than doing something else?
I think so, just because in the times that I've worked with him, the atmosphere is quite heightened. It's theatrical. I can't think of too many films that are so designed, a world that's so art-directed, so worked out according to his kind of really creation of this world.
His films take place in eccentric and unique environments. Many say his films resemble a children's book. I believe that he's leaned into this style even more pronounced after his first venture into stop-motion animation with the movie Fantastic Mr. Fox.
Well, don't take this the wrong way, because it is the opposite of what it sounds like. But I think Wes is one of those people who's managed to maintain a childlike perspective on the world.
But why is this so important? Some of Wes Anderson's critics say that his films are artsy for the sake of being artsy, with no real substance. I wholeheartedly disagree with this. Wes Anderson's art direction is a way of juxtaposing his imagery with his subject matter. Despite the look of them, his films revolve around mature and emotional themes. As playful and as quirky as Anderson's characters are initially perceived, once you pull back the curtains, you understand that they're real people. A deadbeat father, a neglected child, someone who suffers from suicidal thoughts, someone who just wants to be loved. The contrast between the themes and the environment can be jarring at times, and it makes the subject matter more poignant once you've become disillusioned to the world the film's set in.
I always wish I was an orphan. Most of my favorite characters are. I think your lives are more special.
I love you, but you don't know what you're talking about.
I love you too.
I don't think Anderson designs his films with this contrast only in mind. I feel like his design is meant to be hopeful despite the sad subject matter. To tell these character stories, every choice is a calculated one. For instance, look at Anderson's choice for costume design. Beyond them looking great, they tell a small story before even knowing anything about the character. The character of Chaz in the Royal Tenenbaums wears a bright red Adidas tracksuit, but the interesting story choice is Anderson making Chaz's two sons, Ari and Uzi, wear the identical tracksuit to Chaz. The costume is already memorable, but in context, it paints the picture of an overprotective helicopter parent, which we come to find out is something Chaz struggles with being after the loss of his wife.
What's his name?
Sparkplug.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I've had a rough year, Dad.
I know you have, Chazzy.
Wes Anderson uses every tool a filmmaker has. He does so much to create the tone of his films. It doesn't always have to involve the camera. Maybe it's the perfect song. The perfect set. Or the perfect costume.
I've been heartbroken. I don't do too much talking.
But knowing Wes Anderson, it's most likely centered.
How was that?
That was a good toast.